Now we take another important application of the likelihood ratio test, that is in the form of the exponential distribution. So how we use the likelihood ratio test for the exponential distribution? That is some sort of different type of exponential distribution. Let x1, x2 up to xn be the iid random sample with the PDF, that is f of x theta, theta raised to power minus 1 exponential minus x over theta. That is actually the usual exponential distribution. Suppose we are interested to test the hypothesis, that is theta is equal to theta naught versus theta 1 is theta h1, that is theta is not equal to theta naught. So that is some sort of simple versus simple hypothesis. So find the likelihood ratio test for this type of distribution. So how we proceed for this one? So first of all, we know that the likelihood ratio test, that is actually lambda of x, that is actually the ratio of the two maximization of based on the null hypothesis and the maximization based on the full parameter space. So where L hat theta naught, basically that is equal to pi I varies from 1 to n 1 over theta naught exponential into minus x over theta naught. So this can be written as 1 over theta naught raised to power n into exponential minus some x over theta naught. So on the same line, we can also write down the maximum likelihood function based on the full parameter. I just write down directly, that is 1 over theta raised to power n exponential, that is minus some x over theta. Now the likelihood function, actually that is equal to, that is basically the ratio of this one. So I can write it as, that is theta over theta naught raised to power n into exponential. I just take this one to up and this negative will cancel. So this is basically 1 over theta minus 1 over theta naught, or some x common le liya. So this is actually lambda x. So the likelihood ratio test is to reject h naught if lambda x is less than or equal to k, and you know that where k actually is determined by the size condition. Now that is likelihood ratio test, that is we are now going to write down the rejection region, that is theta over theta naught raised to power n exponential into 1 over theta minus 1 over theta naught some x, that is less than or equal to k. So we take the constant term into the other side, so that is actually exponential into 1 over theta minus 1 over theta naught some x, that is less than or equal to k into theta naught over theta raised to power n. Now we take the log. Jab hum iska log lenge to ye exponential khatam ho jayega, 1 over theta minus 1 over theta naught constant ho jayenge, inko dusri side pe le jayenge. So then we have actually some x less than or equal to log of k into theta naught over theta raised to power n divided by 1 over theta minus 1 over theta naught. So if we write down this whole term, let's say we call it k1, so then we have actually some x is less than or equal to k1. Now to find the k1, we must apply the size conditions, and we know that what is the size condition, that is actually the probability some x less than or equal to k1, and that is equal to alpha. So if we actually multiply it, if we can write it as actually 2 over theta naught sum x less than or equal to k2, I just explain it, that is actually alpha, where k2 actually that is 2 over theta naught k1. So we just write down it in term of constant k2. So ye isliye kiya gaya hai because there is a property of the exponential distribution under the null hypothesis that the distribution of 2 over theta naught x jo hai ye chi square with 2 degree of freedom ko follow karta hai. So we have 2 over theta naught sum x hai, so definitely it also follows the chi square distribution but with 2n degree of freedom. So actually we need to find the distribution of the sum x, so we just multiply by this constant so that we may be able to find the distribution of this whole quantity which is chi square with 2n degree of freedom. Since we know that the h1 actually that is based on theta is not equal to theta naught, so the decision rule is reject h0 at level alpha test if 2 over theta naught sum x greater than or equal to chi square with alpha over 2 level and 2n degree of freedom, or this could be 2 over theta naught sum x less than chi square with 1 minus alpha over 2 with 2n degree of freedom. So where you are well aware that chi square alpha over 2 with 2n and chi square 1 minus alpha over 2 with 2n are the lower or the upper and the lower quantiles with 2n degree of freedom.